Battle is an often overused term, but in this case, I think it fits.
Well, we've got a matchup tonight between two teams that love to play it hard. The only two guys that might escape unscathed on either team are the coaches.
And I wouldn't even count on that. It's time for the opening face-off for today's game.
Rips a shot!
He turned the puck over. In behind. Delayed call.
One timer.
It goes wide. He gets called for high sticking.
The stick came up and he's going off to the box.
Up the ball.
He scores!
And halfway through the first, they've got the game's first goal.
The goalie was caught in no man's land on that one. What a beautiful pass that was to set up that goal.
He shoots!
He misses. And the play is offside. Had he been on his forehand, the stick save wouldn't have been made. They're getting ready for the faceoff. He turns the puck over. Delayed penalty coming up. Gathering speed. Here they come again, onto the attack. He's getting called for hooking.
He's not happy about getting that minor, but it's going to the box anyway.
Offside. I thought that might be going in.
He was pretty quick to stop that one.
We're ready for the face-off. The net comes loose and play is stopped. About to drop the puck. Goaltender's out to play the puck. Less than 2 minutes to go in the first period. He turned the puck over. And it's cleared. The ref indicates a delayed call. He gets called for hooking.
A cheap shot on his part, and he's off to the box.
Oh, you can see that the coach doesn't like that call at all, and he's gonna have a word with the official. There's a quick shot that's blocked by the defender. The ref is signaling for the faceoff. There's a crafty little move. Into the slot. They bring it over the line. Ooh, post! From behind the net. They move it into the neutral zone. Back the other way. Picked off. Delayed call. One-timer! Fired the puck just wide of the net. He steals the puck. He's getting called for hooking.
Take a look at the replay, and it's crystal clear what happened. Keep your eye on his stick.
He turned the puck over. Shoots the puck. He turned the puck over. Cleared to safety. Snaps the shot. Just missed the net. We've reached the midway mark of the penalty, and they haven't been able to... Ah, get a shot. And play is stopped as the puck lands on the net. The puck is about to be dropped. Fires it right on! That's blocked and didn't get through. Hit the man in front of the net. Delayed penalty coming up. He gets called for hooking.
And we've got a beautiful angle on this replay. Take a look.
There should be no doubt in your mind about the call. And you can see the coach is having a word with the official because he's not happy about that call. He picks off the puck. Now he just dumps the puck in. Fires it! He scores! Late in the second, it's a two-goal lead.
A backhand like that is so deceptive. It's almost impossible for the goalie to judge where the puck is headed until it's too late.
It looks like they'll carry a two-goal lead into the third period.
As long as they don't lose their focus. That's always the danger with a solid lead.
Shot the puck on the slot.
And he hangs onto the puck for the whistle.
He moved fast to make that save.
Wrist shots are slower than a slap shot, but they're far more accurate.
They're getting ready for the faceoff.
Shoots the puck. Blocked in front of the net. Shoots it! He scores to cut the advantage to one before the second intermission.
When he's coming down on the goalie, he can do so many things. All because of that wicked wrist.
Suddenly their lead is in real jeopardy.
Lots of time to play with only a single goal advantage. I wouldn't be relaxing just yet if I were them.
With a blistering shot.
You cannot, I repeat, cannot go down two goals going into the third. Good save.
He steals the puck. And it's moved into the attacking zone.
Shoots it quickly.
The shots are 5-5. We're ready for the face-off.
He shoots! He scores! And early in the third, they're up by a pair.
That puck was moving so fast, it just rocketed off his stick. I wouldn't want to be setting a screen in front of him.
Couldn't ask for a better start to the period.
No, you certainly couldn't. Two goals up in the third is a lot of breathing room.
A penalty is being called. He's getting called for hooking.
If you're gonna try stuff like that, the least you can do is make sure the ref's not looking.
Wrist shot. Here's another stop.
He turned the puck over. Now they move it out. He intercepted it. Center. Over center. He steals it. They move it out. Turned over. And it's brought in over the line. He intercepted it. Shoots! And he hangs on to the puck. This guy has great puck control, and that's a real asset.
Well, it really does make it easier on the defense knowing he's back there. And when he passes to a teammate, it's usually tape to tape.
Gathering speed. They bring it over the line. Shoots the puck! Makes it hard on net! Cuts in front! Out they come. Blast one right on! He steals the pass. Fired the puck just wide of the net. Shoots the puck. Down to the final 2 minutes of the third period.
Sensational move, he dinks!
He intercepts the pass. Now he shoots the puck in. And it's carried to center. Less than 10 seconds to go in the third. He gave it away. I'm Jim Houston.
And I'm Craig Simpson.
Join us again next time for another great round of hockey.
See you then.